one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment. Did you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rabbit, he choke, he's so mad, but he won't give up. No, he won't have it, he knows. His whole back's at these ropes. It don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's broke. He's so stagnant, he knows. When he goes back to this mobile home, that's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody, better go capture this moment and hope it don't
do better.
Lose his health in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose his health in the music the moment you own it. Your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better.
His soul's escaping through this hole that is gaping. This world is mine for the taking. Make me king as we move toward a new world order. A normal life is boring, but superstardom's close to postmortem. It only grows harder. Homie grows hotter. He blows. It's all over. These fools is all.
Mascot is 9-year-old Cameron Ross, who attends St. Francis of Assisi Primary School and plays for Brunswick Warriors under 9s, and also Ruth Bradley, who is 8 years old and also.
Barry, very low scoring game, bonus point out of it. What's your overall feelings?
Yeah, frustrated. You know, frustrated at the the lack of composure or lack of discipline we had with the ball. Certainly in that, you know, first 35 minutes, you know, you can sort of expect it if you're chasing the game with 10 minutes to go, but when you're trying to build some pressure on teams at the start of a game and you're not willing to do so when you're in, you know, some real good field positions with the ball, then you're going to make things hard for yourself.
Another new half-back partnership. How do we settle that down and get them to play what's in front of them and not almost panic plays, if you want?
Yeah, you know, I think in the first half, I thought the half-backs were doing the job really, really well. You know, they certainly wasn't responsible for, you know, the lack of discipline with the ball. It was just individuals that are lacking patience in terms of, you know, when we look like we're just going to get them on the back foot, you know, forcing a silly offload that hands possession back over to Dewsbury, and that's how they scored those first three tries of theirs to go in at half-time 14-0. You know, we had the ball and we had good field position, but weren't prepared to just ask questions and get to the end of the set. And ultimately, that's why we were 14-0 down.
Three times Lee Brickwood held Cal Price up in the second half that stopped them going further in front and probably taking a bonus point away from us, but that was some terrific defence.
Yeah, you know, Lee's had a really consistent game, and obviously it was a ploy that Dewsbury were using. Obviously Cal's, you know, 7'6" and he's a threat when you're kicking the ball in the air, and even though Lee didn't come up with the ball on every occasion, the fact that he had the composure, which is, you know, what we're like with the ball, he had the composure to be able to hold Cal up and get some assistance from his inside defenders as well, then that was really, really good play.
Dewsbury will have been buzzing from a good result against Featherstone last week, and again you've matched them in terms of field position. what's that next step that's now needed?
Yeah, we just need a bit more guile, and you know, and instead of trying to, you know, create something that's not there, you know, be patient and build pressure and wait for those opportunities and those cracks in the defensive line to you know, to show their face, so to speak. And we weren't prepared to do that today. We were, you know, far too often trying to create something that wasn't there, and ultimately you know, gifted possession back to Dewsbury, and you know, you could see the relief on their face and their body language when we was doing that. And you know, testament to Dewsbury, they were, you know, very physical, and you know, they were hanging in there, you know, and they had the composure to hang in there, because the, you know, we were probably giving them too much ball.
Another tough match next week, we're away at Featherstone. What physically do you think we can match Featherstone with next week? Because coming up the hill and Featherstone down the hill, they always manage to pin everybody down in that 20 metre area.
They do, and physically today, you know, really pleased with how we fared physically. You know, Dewsbury are probably, you know, if not the biggest, one of the biggest sides in the competition. They've got some real, you know, big athletes out there, and you know, we've coped with that well and probably dominated them around the ruck, you know, for large periods of the game. What Featherstone have got in their locker though is, you know, they've got some great creative players, and you know, they've got the physicality and fantastically creative players as well, and you know, everything revolves around Liam Finn, but they've got, you know, other quality players in and around there that can you know, exploit any weaknesses in your defensive line. So you know, it's really important that we match them physically, but you know, but then learn the lessons about applying pressure with the ball ourselves.
Okay, but we've got a bonus point today, so that's a positive.
Yeah, you know, we're doing a lot of really, really good things. You know, we're physically certainly in a lot better condition than we were last year. You know, the players are working really, really hard. The effort and commitment's there. You know, we just need that little bit of guile, you know, when we've got the ball, to be able to, you know, turn some pressure into points and not give the ball over.
Okay, thank you very much.
Charles.